Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Today I want to share some products with you that I personally feel, in my personal experience, gave me results overnight. Of course, no product is a miracle product, but there are some products where you can feel and even see the change overnight. So here are some of the products that in my personal experience have done just that. We need to start with the Peace Out Nose Strips. Nose pore strips? I don't know what they're called. These are hydrocolloid patches specifically designed to fit your nose. These are basically giant pimple patches. And these were around before the hydrocolloid trend happened all over TikTok. And there's a few reasons I like these. Number one, because they stick to my nose. I often find it difficult to find pimple patches that stick to my nose for some reason. I don't know why. They stick just enough and they're not hard to remove. Number two, they work like nose pore strips, removing all that gunk and making your pores look smaller, removing the sebaceous filaments, but they work 1,000 times better in my opinion. The majority of my sebaceous filaments are gone, my pores look smaller, there's no blackheads there. I put these on after cleansing my face onto dry skin, do my skincare routine around it, go to bed, and the next morning, my skin looks so much smoother, less sebaceous-y. Is that, well, yeah, less porous. It does leave you with some wrinkles where it kind of like gathers your skin together, but you take it off, leave it for an hour or whatever, wash your face, do whatever you need to do, and those wrinkles are gone. And they just do work overnight. I've not been massively impressed with the rest of the Peace Out patches. They're like acne dots or pimple patches, whatever, are pretty much the same as every other. They have like de-puffy under eye ones, which aren't great either. Their skincare is interesting. Their retinol stick is very interesting, and I'm kind of testing that out right now. But these just work so good, getting rid of the need for any pore strips. And in fact, they work better than pore strips as well. This is a new launch from COSRX that comes with this free mini Cica toner, the Lip Sleep Special Ceramide Kit. And I struggled to find good lip masks that you wear overnight, but the COSRX one is actually really, really good. This is a lip sleeping mask that moisturizes my lips and keeps them moisturized all throughout the night without being just a layer on top of your lips and waking up with like sticky, gloopy, kind of like still covered in product lip, you know? Ceramides are, of course, fundamental. For our skin and our skin barrier, making our skin stronger if our skin is, you know, weak or damaged, dry and sore. And we have ingredients in here like shea butter that's going to help lock in all that hydration. We also have jojoba seed oil and coconut oil as well. It's scentless and it's just like a good lip balm, but with a more elegant formula. It doesn't feel heavy like Vaseline. I actually don't like the toner that it comes with. It's one of the only COSRX products that I don't really enjoy. It's a bit too simple and watery for me. It's too watery. But if you watched one of my previous lip care videos, which not a lot of you did, judging by the views, I say that I like to hydrate my lips before applying a lip balm, Vaseline, whatever over my lips. This is because I like to hydrate my lips like the rest of my skin and then provide that occlusive layer that's going to moisturize and lock in all that hydration. So even though that isn't the point of this kit, I like to splash a little bit of that toner onto a cotton pad, just place it on my lips for a bit, or even just pat it into my lips when I'm using my toner, then put the lip mask right over. Do that in the evening. Then in the morning, my lips feel soothed, healed, on the way to being fully repaired. I have a kind of like a lip biting problem, lip licking issue as well. So for me, these kind of like nighttime lip treatments are really important. And this one's really good. I really like this one. We have to talk about the Inkey List Succinic Acid. This is a direct spot treatment from the Inkey List, and it contains 2% succinic acid and 2% sulfur to help clear breakouts. Also blackheads as well, without overly drying and damaging the skin. And that's my personal issue with previous spot treatments, is they're too drying. I'm just not a fan of them. They dry out the spot, they leave me with a dark mark, and then that dark mark is left there for way longer than my spot would have ever been on my skin anyway. It's just, I've never tried them. I always avoid them. I was lucky enough to actually try this product a couple months, I think it was, before its actual release. So I got to test it with some really bad spots and some very minuscule breakouts. And honestly, it really did remove the worst of these spots overnight, and I'd wake up with just a very light red mark rather than dry damaged skin that would then just fade naturally over time. Judging by other skincare YouTubers as well, they have the exact same experience. We actually love this product so much that there's a bit of a conspiracy that the Inkey List, we're all on their payroll and that we're all going to have our own skincare line under an Inkey List umbrella, which I didn't know was a thing, but a few people have sent me comments like this. But of course, people ignore the negative reviews we've done on the Inkey List, and you know, the negative feedback we've given them as well. But it was that good. We all just really, really liked it. Now, there was some controversy surrounding this product and the actual ingredient, succinic acid, which Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, as always, has rounded up perfectly. I will link that in the description box. Her video and a bit of a deep dive on her blog as well. But in my opinion and my personal experience, whatever combination of ingredients this is, whatever succinic acid is, it works so well for my skin. I will not use any other direct spot treatment other than pimple patches and this product. I do usually have a bit of a reaction to sulfur, but because I was applying this in small amounts, not all over the skin, I was absolutely fine. This is also £7 and it's gonna last you the longest time. Next is the HOLIKA Good Cera Super Ceramide Cream in Serum. The longest name. I love this product and I really didn't give it enough time and love on this channel. They actually sent me, HOLIKA sent me their whole Sarah something, Good Sarah line, and I turned down a sponsorship with them because at the time there was too many contracts. I didn't think it was that big a interesting product and my channel was starting to look a bit like QVC, you know. But the Good Sarah Super Ceramide in Serum Cream, I don't know what it's called, something like that, was amazing. I don't use it now the weather's warmer, but it was amazing in the winter at helping soothe my dry, damaged, irritated skin. This product helps your skin barrier repair itself whilst also helping to retain that moisture, of course. It has ceramides in. We all know what ceramides are by now. So it really, really does help kind of just smooth everything back over and start your skin from afresh. Afresh from fresh. I'm not doing very well today. I'm just saying things that don't make sense. In a recent video, I actually mentioned how I don't like First Aid Beauty's Ultra Repair Cream. I didn't like how thick it was. It was everything I dislike about a repair cream. It was thick. It didn't really rub into the skin very well. It has a weird kind of like medicinal smell to it. Not that kind of like pharmaceutical smell I like, but it smelled like an ointment, you know? It feels gross on the skin. This HOLIKA product would actually be my dupe for that. It's lightweight, instantly soothing, feels so nice on the skin. Comforting, nourishing, protecting without being thick and heavy. Reducing redness and inflammation. In winter, I was using this pretty much nearly every single night. To be fair, if you have dry skin or combination skin, this is still light enough to use in the hotter weather as well, but I still would use it overnight. We got niacinamide in here, a ton of antioxidants, glycerin, sodium hyaluronate, aloe leaf extract, allantoin, panthenol. It's just packed with skin loving ingredients. And even though I keep saying I use this in winter, it's light enough to use overnight without feeling bogged down and suffocated in layers and layers of product, you know? It's got like that creamy gel serum. What are they called? Like gel creams, you know, where it's like a gel moisturizer but with that creamier texture. It's super light. There is a lot of fragrance in here, which I don't mind fragrance, but I do find it weird when they put a lot of known irritants in products that are meant to repair already irritated skin. I find that a little bit weird. However, this didn't bother me. I'm very bad now at checking ingredients before I try a product. So I'm just like, let's just get it on and see what it's like. And I had no problems with this whatsoever. In fact, I found it very soothing. One product that I really didn't think I was gonna like, because I've tried so many sleeping pillows. I'm a side sleeper, and we're always told that if we want our skin to have less wrinkles, no wrinkles, we should be sleeping on our back. I can't sleep on my back because I get nightmares. I get, sleep paralysis. It's really not a good time for me when I sleep on my back. So I need one of these side sleeping pillows, and I've tried so many and they're so uncomfortable. But one I've really, really been liking is the Nurse Jamie Beauty Bare Age Delay Pillow Memory Foam Edition. It just has the right grooves for me, and that's the only thing that separates it from every other. The shoulder to cheek ratio dent is perfect. It's spot on for me. But also, it's not this weird kind of like bulky shape. It's slim. I sleep with two pillows, so it fits perfectly on top of my other pillow. And it's just a comfortable sleep rather than having to feel like you're sleeping on like a donut and your face is like that. The one pillow I tried, I was kind of like stuck at the end of it because there was just a groove either side of it. And I was just sleeping on one end of my pillow, which meant I was right at the side of my bed or bang in the middle of my bed. And it just didn't feel right, you know? So yeah, of course with that, you don't see difference overnight, but hopefully in the long run, I'm going to start seeing a difference when it comes to the, you know, like pillow lines in my face. And I don't really care about anti-aging. I don't mind aging. Hopefully we all get to age. But I just don't want my skin to be pushed up and, you know, I can feel it. And it's also nice to feel like your product isn't on your pillow all the time. But yeah, I just thought I'd throw that in because I recently started using it. So it's still a new thing. But I think it's one of the better kind of size sleeping pillows that I've used. Let me know your products at work overnight in the comments down below. I know that, you know, there's not a lot of things at work just like that. But let me know the products you see the most improvements with in the shortest amount of time in the comments down below. You can watch some more product reviews here and some general light entertainment here, and I will see you over there.